memory. That was good as all about. By the way, why watch as a ray? No longer straight out. My love is not love. Who's the blue guy? What would it be an eye? Your voice will kill. Rise up for existence of me. My bed is complete with no reason.
God! Why? Thank you. Guinness. We are a disgrace.
Wholesale agent of death.
Slaughter of the unborn.
Staggers.
A horrific disgrace.
And it really is disgrace.
Slaughter of the innocent
is going to be for our national and eternal peril.
We'll be right back. Let's view America by this standard now and take into account abortion as it has been practiced in this country, especially following the Roe versus Wade decision in 1973. And if you look at us soberly from that perspective, even with all our economic might and military power and our technological prowess, you must judge that we are a disgrace. Surveys indicate that something like 80% of Americans describe themselves as Christian. And yet, in this same country, about 38 million babies have been aborted in the last 28 years. This does not compute. We can, however, compute the magnitude of the carnage by comparing it with some other grim statistics. In 4 years of World War II, the United States lost about 292,000 troops in combat. In the past 4 years in the United States, we lost about 5 million babies. That loss is 17 times our loss in World War II in a comparable period of time. If you were to put a gold memorial star in the window of every home in America that has lost a baby through abortion, this country would form a galaxy of disgrace. Use World War II as a comparison again. World War II was just unparalleled in the loss of human life. Now, we often think of the 6 million Jews who were exterminated under Hitler's regime. So let's start there with that just mind-boggling number. And then we can add to it. Let's add the 7 million Russian troops that died fighting Nazi Germany. And then let's add the 7 million Russian civilians that died because of the war. Now we have to add the 19 million citizens in North China who died there as a result of Imperial Japan's scorched earth policy. And only now do we come up to the number of losses that we have experienced in the United States through abortion just since Roe versus Wade. The only difference is that in World War II, just some of the casualties were babies. In the present case, all of them are. If the raw numbers don't convey it to you, let's try a spatial approach. The National Vietnam Memorial is a black wall that lists the names of over 58,000 Americans killed in that war. That wall is 492 sobering feet long. Suppose we made a similar memorial for babies that have been lost in America through abortion since Roe versus Wade. We assign a name to every one of those babies, and we make a similar wall. How long would that wall run? The Vietnam one runs 492 feet. The abortion memorial wall would run 60 miles. Even that's hard to get your hands on, so let me further illustrate it spatially. If we placed one end of the abortion wall in Allentown, the other end would cross the state line and run all the way to Wilmington, Delaware. If you put the end of the Vietnam memorial wall right here at this pulpit, it would almost reach to the car wash next door. If you put the end of the abortion wall here at this pulpit, it would reach to Scranton. On January 22nd, oddly enough, the anniversary of Roe versus Wade, I drove to Scranton for a funeral. And it blows my mind to think that even at 65 miles per hour, I would be driving by the names of all those babies for over an hour. Now you let that all sink in. And then ask yourself why God has not blotted the United States from the face of his earth. The only thing more staggering than the magnitude of the slaughter is the magnitude of God's patience.